In just over 20 years, Viking Cruises has gone from a startup to the industry leader of river cruises. As part of Viking's recent naming ceremony, the princess and I were invited on a 3-day mini cruise. Well, we are back and have a lot to report from our first ever river cruise. I'm DB from eatsleepcruise.com, and this is our Viking River Cruise review and ship tour. Boarding a Viking longship is like checking into a 5-star resort. Once you arrive at the vessel, you can casually stroll on board right to deck 2 to complete the quick check-in process. You embark on an open and inviting atrium on deck 2 with guest services to your immediate left. This 2-story atrium will become your regular meeting spot for group tours or when preparing to disembark at each port of call. Located at this midship area is also a small gift shop, offering some logo gear and other apparel that you might want to take home as a souvenir. Forward on deck 2 is the main dining room. Open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, the main dining room offers an elegant and simple design, like many of the public indoor venues. Each side of the room is lined with floor-to-ceiling windows to provide plenty of light during the day, as well as amazing views of the scenery ashore. If you head aft on deck 2, you'll find passenger staterooms. On deck 2 starboard, you'll find veranda staterooms with a true balcony. Port side of deck 2 will be the smaller French balcony staterooms, which feature a sliding glass door that turns your entire cabin into a veranda. While deck 2 and 3 are the center hub of interior activity, there is also deck 1. Here, the only public venues are the standard staterooms. These 150 square foot cabins feature all of the same amenities as other rooms, but only offer a rectangular window that is at water level. After this recent naming ceremony, Viking Cruises now has over 50 longships. The good news is that these longships all have the same layout and design. This enables the cruise line to focus on the ports of call and itineraries while still delivering an elegant and reliable cruise experience all over the globe. While the features and amenities across these vessels are identical, it doesn't mean that this cruise line is mass produced. In fact, the chairman eloquently stated that luxury is simplicity, and he prides himself on the line's attention to detail. The Scandinavian-inspired decor is stunning, yet functional, allowing cruisers to have easy access to all of the public venues and the sites surrounding the ship. The Viking Lounge on Deck 3, midship, is a focal point. With a traditional setup, the lounge offers comfortable seating, a bar, and a small cutout that acts as a stage for nightly entertainment. On Viking River Cruises, you won't find casinos, art auctions, or over-the-top stage productions. Instead, you can attend destination-focused entertainment and enjoy low-key musical acts in the lounge during the evenings. Further forward on the ship is the Aquavit Terrace, one of our favorite spots on the entire vessel. With al fresco seats, as well as some indoor tables and chairs, your meals at the terrace are filled with great food and stunning views. Located at the very forward of the ship, the terrace was not only a great place to dine, but also a relaxing spot for afternoon tea or for some scenic cruising. You will not want to overlook the coffee bars on deck 3. These self-serve stations brew up American coffee, teas, lattes, and also feature some small pastries and snacks throughout the day. You cannot pass by this area without snagging one or two of the cruise line's signature oatmeal cookies. Lastly, the midship areas on deck 3 include a library with a thoughtful collection of curated books specific to the region and locations being visited by the ship. There's also a few computers great for checking into your flight or for quickly skimming your email. Keep in mind that Viking River Cruises offer free Wi-Fi, so you can use your own devices anywhere on the ship if you feel like surfing the web or posting to social media. Heading aft on deck 3, you will find staterooms, including the veranda staterooms like the one we stayed in during our trip, as well as the veranda suite and French balcony staterooms. Deck 4 on Viking longships is the open-air deck. On the forward part of the deck, you'll find tables, chairs, and umbrellas. this is a perfect place to enjoy the weather and some scenic sailing. Sit back and relax with a drink from the bar while cruising down the river might just be the best way to spend some idle afternoon time. In the midship area, there's a plentiful selection of reclining loungers. These sun chairs are something you'd actually expect to find on an ocean cruise ship's pool deck. While we did not have any time for sunbathing, these loungers also offer the opportunity for you to rest and relax with some gorgeous, uninhibited views of the shoreline. Towards the back of the ship, there's also a walking track and a small putting green area to help keep you active. Lastly, all Viking cruise ships have an organic herb garden on the sun deck. This small attention to detail adds fresh flavor to the regionally inspired cuisine served throughout the ship. All Viking longships have two dining venues. The main dining room is open for set hours each day for a sit-down breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The breakfast menu remains the same throughout the cruise and includes additional small buffet with a custom omelet station. Open from 7 a.m. to 10 each day, the restaurant's breakfast also include made-to-order options like pancakes and eggs benedict. On select days of our trip, the restaurant was also open for lunch, offering a pretty standard menu along with few daily specials. This sit-down lunch had a salad bar as well as some other quick-serve options. For dinner, the restaurant on Viking Cruises offered a traditional setup that will make cruisers feel right at home. Every night, there's standard options that included a steak, chicken, and fish dish. In addition, there was a rotational menu which switched every evening, featuring locally inspired cuisine. While this sounds pretty typical, the food on Viking River Cruises is anything but ordinary. The other dining spot was the Aquavit Terrace. From 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. every morning, it offered a continental breakfast. The light fare remained the same throughout the trip and was a perfect quick meal. For lunch, the venue offered a small buffet consisting of a salad bar, select sandwiches, and a few warm sides. While it's a limited menu, the food was leaps and bounds better than the typical MDR lunch on larger ships. Perhaps my favorite feature was the made-to-order grill. For this abbreviated Rhine River voyage, we stopped at 4 different ports. These stops included a morning day trip to Basel, Switzerland, as well as stops in Strasbourg, France, and 2 stops in Germany. Viking offers travelers 1 complimentary tour per port, which is often a city tour. We highly recommend taking these panoramic tours, as the small group size allows you to enjoy an up-close and personal experience of the historical and cultural sites. With some of the most knowledgeable tour guides and exclusive access, Viking delivers an immersive and informative day ashore. One morning, touring Lucerne, Switzerland, we were able to trek through this awe-inspiring city with the Swiss Alps as our backdrop, exploring the streets of Strasbourg, including a few stops that are part of the upcharge food tour, had us hungry for more of the city. Likewise, our tours in Germany gave us a good sample of these cities, visiting highlights like the Heidelberg Castle and the Gutenberg Museum for a private viewing of one of the Gutenberg Bibles. Although it was only a few days, this mini cruise was a welcome departure from our typical mega ship cruises. While many cruise ships are destinations themselves, Viking focuses on its ports of call. The cruise line succeeds by offering culturally rich itineraries enhanced by superb service and onboard amenities, delivering exceptional food and personalized service without any of the other big box distractions. Viking allows you to truly see the world in comfort. It's also the small touches that separate Viking from other cruise lines. Bottled water, premium coffee and tea, and soft drinks are all included in the cruise fare. House poured wines and beer are also served with meals at no additional cost. As the industry leader in river cruises, Viking knows how to cater to its target market. The cruise line delivers a superbly executed experience that provides all the benefits of cruising without the headaches that you can experience on larger vessels. The Princess and I thoroughly enjoyed our sample cruise, and we look forward to experiencing a full river cruise in the near future. And there you have it. That is our Viking River Cruise longship review and tour. But of course, we'd love to hear from you. drop us a comment below with your experiences sailing on Viking Cruises river ships. I'm DB from eatsleepcruise.com. And if you enjoyed this video, we'd really appreciate it if you gave it a big thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe down below. That way you get notified whenever we put out brand new videos. You can also find us all over social media at Eat Sleep Cruise. And thanks again for watching.